Lewis is with some of the Golden Boys in Weymouth now.
Paul, it is a fantastic night here at the Cove Inn pub in Weymouth. Australian team headquarters, they're all here to celebrate with these guys. Nathan Adorigine and Jensen, congratulations, gold medalists, guys. How does it feel?
Yeah, it's amazing. We've been sort of waiting for this for 4 years now, and you know, to finally do the job in front of so many fans here, it's just been an incredible day.
Ian, obviously you guys had this one sewn up before today. You had a couple of days to relax, and this one could have been a little bit of a cruise. Were there still a few nerves getting to that start line?
The nerves are probably coming a couple of days ago when we were still fighting for it, but we had a 28-point lead going into today, and the most points you can get in a medal race is 20, so it was a relief when it was all over.
All you had to do was not get disqualified, and you managed to avoid that. Best behaviour?
best behaviour out there, and we're just trying to... There was a real fight going on for bronze, so we were just trying to stay clear and making sure we didn't jeopardise anyone else's Olympics.
It's been a fantastic result for both of you, obviously, particularly Nathan after Beijing, where you had the gold medal in sight. You could see the finish line and you had a bit of a disaster capsizing. Does this make that feel any better?
Oh, for sure. Like, after the last games, I was gutted for like a year, and you know, it takes a long time to come back from things like that, and we've seen that happen to people here this week. And you know, you go up and tell them, you know, I know how you feel, but there's nothing more you can do than wait 4 years and have another go at it. And you know, Ian and I have been working so hard the last 4 years, and our coach has been a rock for us and made sure that, you know, everything we do is about winning the gold medal. And yeah, we did it with a day to spare, and it's an amazing feeling.
You guys have been mates for quite a few years now. You only got together as a sailing team in 2009. Why do you guys work so well together?
I think it's probably because we've known each other for so long. You know, like, we've sailed against each other, we've sailed with each other, and some of my strengths are in areas that Nate's still very good at, but not as good, and Nate's really good at stuff that I'm not so good at, so it just meshes together well.
There are a lot of people watching in Wanji at the moment. I hope got that right. Yeah. What do you want to say to them back home at your home sailing club?
Yeah, we really want to thank all the supporters. We've got a lot of people from Wanji here, and for those who couldn't make it, I believe there have been parties all night long, and you know, we're looking forward to getting home, seeing them, and celebrating, you know, these gold medals that we've worked so hard for, and everyone's been a huge support to us, and you know, we can't thank them enough.
Huge support here as well. Everyone wearing T-shirts with your names on them. I do want to know, though, what's with the nickname Joobs? Is it Goobs? Is it something you can say on television?
Yeah. It's not much of a story, to be honest. I've had it since I was 3 or 4 years old, and my next-door neighbours actually gave it to me, and it's just carried.
It's carried all the way to Weymouth, where you guys are gold medalists. Guys, gold medalists in the 49er. Give them a round of applause. Guys, it's back to you.
Brilliant, Ben. Thank you very much.